Derek, she is a beauty.
That's old school Weil-McLain. That's like 1950 Weil-McLain.
This is an antique steam boiler for this home here on Long Island in New York.
Take a look at what this is. It's a gas valve, right?
Yeah.
What do you see next to it?
That's the gas line to the gas valve.
Well, if you take the cover off,
see it burning.
You'll see that you have this pilot tubing leaving a small valve there, and it goes down here, and it goes to the pilot burner, which is back there, right? Pretty crazy, huh? So, unlike newer gas valves, yesterday you ran into an example where a Burnham, you know, boiler, it's about, what, 15 years old that boiler was? Pilot was out, right? Because the thermal couple was bad, right?
Here, it's getting gassed 24/7, and it don't know if it's lit or not. Right, it's just always on. So the gas is always flowing. So if the flame is not out, it'll just keep going.
Yeah,
crazy. Weil-McLain, look at that. It's a Series E6, 175,000 BTU boiler. Crazy.
But that is how old that is. So here is that gas setup. You have your half inch gas coming in. You have a gas pressure regulator, right? And here's that gas valve. Now, the gas valve also has a little, looks like pilot tubing here, going to like a little thermocouple looking thing, right?
Yeah.
But also notice that you have this wire, which has like some metal on it, going to two terminals in the gas valve. Yeah. So this is a millivolt gas valve. God help the homeowner when this dies, because you have to redo everything in its entirety. So, but it's pretty good stuff. This is a very, very old, yet still functional. And if you were to replace this today, you're not gaining any efficiency. And we're going to prove that by doing a combustion test. You're going to see what kind of numbers this thing puts out. Except the combustion analyzer.
All right, so our combustion analyzer probe is inside the top of the boiler before it gets diverted with air from the diverter and then before it goes up the flue. But take a look at our numbers. 535 temperature and still climbing. Right? But take a look at this number, right? 76.2%. And it may go up a little bit, but this is high. This is approaching a temperature, a stack temperature of an oil-fired boiler. Now, typically with steam, you have higher stack temperatures because you're boiling water and not going to like 180 degrees for like most hydronic boilers, but to approach almost 570 degrees, that is insane, right? But we have 9.5% of O2, so that's a little bit higher than where it should be, but 18 parts per million, 19 of carbon dioxide. Now let's scroll down a little bit. And CO2, a little bit lower than it could be, but the battery's dying. You gotta plug that in. It did say dead battery when you turned it on, right? All right,
so Derek removed the two wires going to the pressuretrol. He also removed the pressure gauge. And now he's gonna pull out or unthread the pigtail from the top of the number 67 low water cutoff. And we're gonna make sure that the pigtail is clean. Okay, take that off if you need to.
Yeah, it has.
Yep. Lefty loosey, righty tighty, Derek. I don't know how many more times I can tell you that, but lefty loosey, righty tighty. I was setting you up, Derek. You were going right the first time.
You were setting me up?
Yeah, I was saying lefty loosey, righty tighty. But you need to, listen, the way you're holding that wrench is retarded. I mean, that channel lock.
I was going the right way. You was really saying
that. I'm just saying lefty loosey, righty tighty. That's all. I'm just giving you some knowledge. Yeah, it's hot, huh? Mucho caliente aquí. See? And then maybe get a rag ready. Right, remember I did say be careful because if there's pressure or water in there, you're gonna feel it, right? You're in a little bit of a dilemma, aren't you?
Should I just let it all out?
Well, what you could do slowly take off that cap. That's the cap, by the way. Mm-hmm. All right, take it out carefully. Okay, now go clean that. Make sure it's clear. Go. No, don't blow it here. You're going to get shit all over the place. Come on. Go to the sink around the corner. Move quickly because you're draining the boiler as you're doing that. Right there. All right, so when we had the pigtail removed, I just took some water out of the bottom of the low water cutoff until the sight glass was below the top of the low water cutoff, and we weren't getting any more water out of there. And as I was saying to Derek before he started removing everything, like, be careful when taking them off. Be prepared for pressure to come out of there, and if it's system's been running, you will have boiling hot water coming out of there, and you can severely injure yourself and burn yourself. So, Derek, stop playing with it. Just get it on there. Okay? Why you move it? Don't move it counterclockwise, because now you're loosening it, right?
Yeah.
That's why I was saying stop playing with it. Put it back the way it was, because when you
back... It was that way.
What was that way?
This position.
Really?
Yeah, because it has to go like this.
Okay. All right, while Derek is reassembling the piping on top of the pigtail to reinstall the pressure troll and the pressure gauge, let's take a look at the history of this Weil-McLain. We're gonna flip over the front cover and take a look at an old LWCO service sticker where the first service record is May 29th, 1975. And that looks like P. O'Donnell, PM. And then the next service, it could be 77 or 1979, but it's 11-11, so November 11th, 1977. Looks like CH was here for a thermal on night cycle. So I'm going to say thermostat on the night cycle. That must have been the service then. Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, we're going back almost 50 years. 50 years ago. Wow, yeah. May 29th, 1975. 50 years ago, someone wrote those words for preventative maintenance. That's insane. June 20th, 1981, another PM. Looks like the same guy was back 5 years ago. It's the same exact handwriting. P. O'Donnell, same guy. Wow. Referred blow-off valve. I guess they need a new valve there. Clean base of chimney. And then in 1983. Oh, SG was here and installed the blow-off valve. And then in 1987, flush the low water cutoff. And also in 1987, we have ordered float assembly and blow off. And then, many years later, pipe doctor's here. And on 12/29 of 2022, we cleaned out the low water cutoff. We blew out pigtail, replaced sight glass nuts and washers, and replaced the relief valve.
Daniel did that. And then last November 4th, preventative maintenance and steam vents, Daniel was there as well. And then today, the 31st, Halloween, 2025, MD, and Derek for preventative maintenance. And we're going to finish that combustion analysis, put the new print out there, and put a copy on the put a copy of that combustion analysis on the email receipt that we're going to give the homeowner. Now, it's a far cry from 50 years ago till today. But one thing that has not changed is that this boiler, this Weil-McLain boiler, has been providing decades of reliable service. As antiquated as it is, with literally only two safety components, one being the low water cutoff and two being the pressuretrol. Insane. Absolutely insane. There's no rollout switch. There's no spill switch. There's no automatic vent damper. Insane.
Good old Weil-McLain.
All right, we're back to doing a combustion test. I didn't like the numbers we were getting, so I just drilled a hole in the back of the diverter box. This is fine.
There's a big giant hole at the bottom of it. You think this hole's gonna make a difference? No, this is perfectly fine. If anything, you're giving it more oxygen and more draft air to go up. Anyway, 530 degrees, 9.5 of O2, 22 parts per million of carbon monoxide. And that's the magic number, folks. We're making sure that's under 50, and we are. Gross efficiency, 76.5%. Derek's gonna clipboard this number.
Okay.
And then we're gonna escape. And he's going to back out and do a draft measurement. And he's gonna hit start, and it's gonna count down for 11 seconds. And then we're gonna put the probe up the bottom of the draft hood and get a draft measurement of the air diverted with the exhaust gases. So right up there, boom, straight up. Hold that there. We're gonna see we have negative pressure on the draft, and we're gonna hit that clipboard button again. And then Derek is gonna print the results with the IR printer. Just put it right there, boom, hit print. And there you have it, folks. Today's date, time, and a validation of, we proved the boiler was performing properly and safely on today's date.